On the 27th of May, the first group of tourists returned to Israel. The country's borders had been closed for over a year due to the coronavirus pandemic. The Day of Friendship and Support for Religious Communities in the Holy Land was held in Abu Ghosh. It was an opportunity to show solidarity through the purchase of handicrafts with the congregations present in the country, which have been damaged by the long absence of pilgrims due to the pandemic. At the Jerusalem and Bethlehem sites of the Terra Sancta schools, high school graduation diplomas were handed out to high school graduates. The second Apostles of Palestine competition ended on the 7th of June at the Terra Sancta school in Bethlehem. The aim of the initiative is to introduce young Christians from the land of Jesus to the Bible. From the site of Calvary, an in-depth study of the open side of Jesus from which blood and water flowed, together with Frederick Mantz of the Studium Biblicum Franciscanum of the Custody of the Holy Land. The first group of tourists arrived in Israel on the 27th of May after the borders had been closed for more than a year due to the coronavirus pandemic. Welcoming them on arrival from the United States, Israel's Minister of Tourism, Orit Farkash HaKohen, said,
"We are back to normal and our cities are vibrant and alive. Everything is open in Israel, from restaurants to hotel, concerts, the beaches, the markets, natural parks, the resorts, and sporting venues. Everything is now safely open."
Israel allowed a limited number of tourists to enter the country, provided they were organized in groups to facilitate traceability in order to avoid the spread of coronavirus variants. The announcement of the reopening of the borders was welcomed by tourist agencies, which made every effort to organize trips.
"We waited a year and 2 months to reopen the incoming tourism sector, and we were very happy with the start of the pilot program. 1 minute to register, and after 9 minutes the list was closed. It was a great success, and we are honored to host the first group of tourists. Finally, it will be possible to visit the Holy Land.
We have enjoyed so much what we have seen. Everything has been open and it has been safe and wonderful. We are very glad to be back in the country. Now we have the opportunity to go into the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, and we're going to be focused on the fact that God has done incredible things for us, and this marks the place of the resurrection of Jesus."
Preparations to welcome more tourists and pilgrims continue. "We ask tourists who want to come to be vaccinated and to take the PCR swab. We have also decided to expand the pilot program in coordination with the Ministry of Tourism to welcome 1,000 tourists soon." Charles Rodot de Châtenay, who works at the European Commission representation in Jerusalem, and his wife Carol started an online fundraising campaign and, together with a group of volunteers, organized a Day of Friendship and Support for Religious Communities in the Holy Land, a cultural and artistic event held at the Benedictine Monastery of Abu Ghosh to promote the handicrafts made by local religious congregations.
"The idea of this day is to gather the different religious communities who have been severely impacted by the COVID crisis, notably from a financial point of view, as they don't receive any resources from the pilgrims that they welcome usually and to whom they sell their handicrafts."
"Our livelihood depends on tourism, but the monastery was closed for a whole year. We sell what we grow here, like fruit. All our products are organic. We are happy that normality has returned to the village, and we are ready to welcome visitors again."
P People who took part in this initiative were able to buy jams, soap, honey, olive oil, drawings, and many other products made by the 12 exhibiting groups present. We came here to stand in solidarity with the local Christian community.
I came for buying gifts and many things to help these people because of the coronavirus. There are no tourists, no pilgrims.
The fundraising campaign was supported by the Latin Patriarchate of Jerusalem and the Consulate General of France in Jerusalem.
This initiative is a blessing because it's a kind of internal solidarity, community with community, for all our religious community, which are doing a wonderful job in the hospital, in the schools, in many other activities. I hope that these initiatives, with many other initiatives, not just here but all over the world, we can keep supporting the Christians in Orient.
The day also included guided tours of the Benedictine monastery, which houses a 1,000-year-old Crusader church containing frescoes depicting the lives of Jesus and the apostles, whose faces were obliterated during Islamic rule. Muslims do not depict the human face, so we notice that the church has been preserved, but the faces of the people inside have been erased. For one day, the sanctuary was the destination of an internal flow of tourists, and Charles Rodot de Châtenay expressed the hope that more initiatives of this kind would be organized in the future, adding that Christian groups could also be supported through various websites.
So we really encourage those who want to support the religious communities here to donate even small amounts on this website to support the 12 communities who are present today here.
With study, determination and faith, the graduates of the Terra Sancta schools in Jerusalem and Bethlehem managed to overcome the coronavirus and isolation and regularly completed their last year of high school, thus obtaining their high school diploma. This group is very important to me. We all know the difficulties that we've had to face this year, but the children have been able to challenge and overcome them all with the help of prepared and competent teachers and with the support of their parents. I'm sure that theirs will be an important contribution to the future of this holy city.
We managed to achieve these results despite the coronavirus pandemic, thanks to all the teachers and Father Brahim.
On the 4th of June, in the auditorium of Notre Dame, there was the graduation ceremony for the 67th class of graduates from the Terra Sancta school in Jerusalem. The ceremony was attended by Brother Francesco Patton, Custos of the Holy Land, Brother Ibrahim Faltas, Director of the Terra Sancta Schools, Consul General of Italy in Jerusalem, Giuseppe Fedeli, and the Ambassador of the State of Palestine to the Holy See, Issa Cassisier. Also present were Professor Maurizio Oliviero, Rector of the Italian University of Perugia, Josef Hasbun, Regional Director of the Pontifical Mission in Jerusalem, and the director of the primary school, Sister Farida Nasser, as well as the teachers and families of the graduates. In his speech, Father Faltas explicitly asked the graduates to recite the prayer of St. Francis, "Lord, make me an instrument of your peace," so that the values on which the Franciscan principles are based can be heard from near and far.
In our school, we are trying to educate particularly Christians and Muslims to be able to live together, as Pope Francis says in the encyclical Fratelli Tutti and in the document of Abu Dhabi, to work together in order to build a fraternity all around the world and in order to give a contribution to peace.
The students presented an end-of-year essay with music, songs and poems and thanked their parents and those who accompanied them on this journey. I thank my school because it prepared me for university and because it allows me to build my future. From here, I will start my path in the field of programming and technology. These are the young people of Jerusalem, the young people of the Jaffa Gate and the Damascus Gate, the young people of the Holy City, the young people of the custody of the Holy Land. The Holy Land has been working in these places for 800 years, and has always done the impossible to preserve the people and the stones of these holy places. The following day, at the Terra Sancta school in Bethlehem, a city that has been named capital of Arab culture, 82 students were awarded their high school diplomas. There was also Father Jamal Kader, Director General of the Latin Patriarchate Schools, together with representatives of civil institutions such as the Prefect of the Governorate of Bethlehem, General Kamel Hamid. At the beginning of the ceremony, the Millennium Hall of St. Francis of Assisi was reopened after a period of restoration, where the coat of arms of the custody of the Holy Land and a large image of the Star of the Nativity were installed. It is a sports center with international standards, but also a museum with works of art created by the students of the Terra Sancta School and the Piccirillo Handicraft Center. In his speech, Brother Ibrahim Faltas encouraged the students to leave a mark in life that distinguishes them from others, he said, and that their mark be honest, wise, rational, and moral. 95% of the inhabitants of Bethlehem work in tourism, and there have been no tourists for 17 months. Today we want to bring joy back to these students and their families.
In Bethlehem, during the year, we tried to support in every way the students and the families in a very difficult period.
Brother Ibrahim Faltas then praised the generosity of the Italian University of Perugia, which over the years has financed over 300 scholarships for students in Bethlehem.
In spite of everything, it has been a really good year. The time has flown by. We are very happy to have reached this milestone.
At the end of the ceremony, the students received their certificates amidst applause from their parents.
I wish all the best to all the students, not simply all the best for the graduation, but all the best for the life, because the graduation is like a door open to the life.
As graduates of the Terra Sancta schools, we will not forget to carry the Franciscan message, a message of love, of peace, and fraternity. On the 7th of June, on the stage of the Terra Sancta school in Bethlehem, the second Apostles of Palestine competition dedicated to Bible knowledge came to an end. At the ceremony were Monsignor Pier Battista Pizzaballa, Patriarch of Jerusalem of the Latins, the Mayor of Bethlehem, Anton Salman, Monsignor Giacinto Bulos Marcuzzo, Father Khaled Kamwa, General Supervisor of the competition, Father Yaqub Abu Saada, Parish Priest of the Melkite Catholic Parish of Bethlehem, Sister Agnes El Yaqub, Superior General of the Rosary Sisters, and Brother Ibrahim Faltas, Director of the Terra Sancta School. Several religious communities and the families of contestants were also present. The evening began with a Bible reading, followed by the Palestinian National Anthem. The competition was organized by the Sons of the Earth Association with the support of the Latin Patriarchate of Jerusalem and the Pontifical Mission to the Holy Land.
We need new instruments, new ways to teach our children what is the basis, the foundation of our faith, which is the Bible. So, and this is a modern way to let them enter into what will be constitutive of their own identity.
The initiative is aimed at ninth grade students throughout Palestine, from Gaza to Jenin. But due to current conditions, Gaza was unable to participate. We are addressing eighth grade students because this is the age group where adolescence begins, and we try to offer them insights into the Bible and our mission as Christians in Palestine.
The celebration began with some welcome speeches and artistic and musical performances by the Bethlehem Academy of Music Band. In his speech, Patriarch Pizzaballa stressed the importance of teaching religious culture to students in Christian schools. He announced that the Patriarchate will open two institutes to teach the Bible and theology in Arabic, one in Bethlehem and one in Nazareth or Haifa.
The value of the prize will be determined by the organizing committee, according to the economic conditions of the contestants. A pilgrimage to Italy with a visit to the Vatican and a meeting with the Pope, or a cash prize.
In the final stage of the competition, 10 contestants competed for the top 3 places, for which some prizes were awarded.
We started the first phase of the competition online, as it was difficult for the students to gather in one place because of the coronavirus pandemic. However, all 10 finalists received a prize of $100 for reaching the fourth and final stage of the competition. The last round took place on the computer, and the questions asked to the students and the correct answers were not announced to the audience. The jury was made up of priests, lay Bible experts, and the Sisters of the Congregation of the Holy Rosary. At the end, to the applause of those present, the names of the three winners were announced: Katia Gattas, Loren Khoury, and Wassim Salibi.
It is a wonderful feeling to win a competition related to the Word of God, because no matter how much you read it, you will never reach a complete knowledge of the information about God. Every time you open the Bible, you find a new message, a new information, which brings a new spirit within you. I wish all the students in the coming year to take part in this competition, because it is a wonderful competition. In the first year, we had 200 students. This year, we had 400. This indicates that we are indeed proclaiming the gospel to a multitude of people.
The Basilica of the Holy Sepulchre is in Jerusalem. It houses the places where Jesus suffered his passion, the tomb where his body was laid to rest, the stone of anointing where he was prepared for burial, and Calvary where he was crucified. Not even his heart was spared. In this holy place, Jesus' heart beat for the last time. The heart is man's most important vital organ. In the Bible, the heart is not simply the symbol of love. It is the heart that thinks, that decides, that listens. Ben Sira, the wise man, said, "The Lord created you with a heart to think." The most important commandment is to love the Lord with all your heart. The evangelist John recounts in detail this great proof of Jesus' love and mercy, where he quotes, "But when they came to Jesus, seeing him already dead, they did not break his legs, but one of the soldiers opened his side with a spear, and immediately blood and water gushed out."
Et Jésus aussi a un cœur. Et c'est la fête du Sacré-Cœur qui justement célèbre l'amour de Dieu pour les hommes.
Jesus has a heart too. It is precisely the Feast of the Sacred Heart that celebrates God's love for mankind. God so loved the world that he sent his Son there. And from the side of Christ flowed water and blood when the soldier pierced him. What does this mean? We must remember the scene in paradise when God created Adam asleep. God opened his side and took out a rib to form Eve. From the side of Christ, which is opened, the church, the new Eve, is born. And it is she who, through the sacraments of water and blood, will regenerate the world. This is a first interpretation. A second interpretation is drawn from chapter 47 of the book of Ezekiel. Ezekiel sees a new temple under which water flows. Jesus is the new temple, and from his side the spring of living water flows and pours into the Dead Sea, making its salt water drinkable. There will also be small fish. The little fish are the Christians who must live in the water, who must remember the water of their baptism. A fish that is out of the water dies. An organ essential to life, much quoted in the Word of God, it can signify the intimate thirst of the human being. Thought, memory, feeling, and decision. The Bible mentions the word heart almost 1,000 times, of man and of God. The heart is almost always, 80% of the time, the symbol of love.